This video is not made for kids. It's for older fans and adults. So, like, enjoy the bloody video.
Where am I? Hello? Hello? Who's there? Show yourself. Show yourself. Who are you?
You know who I am, but you choose to forget me.
What do you mean?
You knew me, but you did. You chose to forget that I led you down the path that you followed.
I don't know what you mean.
The next day, news had spread about the accident, but no one had told Percy about the newer discoveries, which he had sadly had the unpleasantries of finding out this very day.
Anything new?
This is a terrible time for Soldar.
Edward told me that Thomas is slipping in and out of somewhat of a coma.
A coma? How? Do they know what's causing it?
They haven't a clue.
They say he's in the bag of the steamworks currently. If I'm honest with you, I'll bet he's probably doing this to avoid work. It's bad enough Gordon is out of commission.
That was all Percy had heard. He began to puff away scared.
I don't have time! Oh no!
The engines looked as they saw Percy leave.
Percy, wait!
Do you reckon he heard everything?
Of course he did. He's always eavesdrop on conversations such as this.
Bullocks.
Thank you. didn't go further, Percy. You only experience more heartbreak.
No, I want to see him!
No, Percy, it's too late.
No, it's never too late!
Percy! Don't you realize why it's so quiet around here? They've done all they could. Thomas has fallen into a coma.
Doggy!
Percy, we're sorry.
Adam, take Percy back to Farquhar. He doesn't need to be here.
Right, lads.
What the?
Edward? Everything okay?
Everything's fine. Sorry, you just startled me, sir. That's all.
My apologies, Edward. You remember Alan Croft?
Alan?
Hello, Emma. It's been a long time. How have you been?
It's been such a long time! It's been 40 years! Where have you been?
I've been at Barrow, working as a cleaner.
Oh, Alan, it's been so long, it's felt so much!
Same old Emma.
Same, Alan. What are you doing here, though?
Sir Topham Hatt asked me to come over. It's about my brother.
Oh, him.
Also, I am so sorry to hear about what happened to Thomas.
I have a feeling that Stephen is the one behind that, but we just don't know.
Well, Alan will be staying at Topham Manor. He's our guest tomorrow. Stepney will be arriving tomorrow, as well as some of the engines from the island of New Chester, along with a new diesel.
A new diesel, sir?
Sir Topham chuckled.
Don't worry, Edward. I've been told she's a friendly diesel.
Oh, thank God. What's her name?
Mavis. I'll meet her at Vicarstown tomorrow when the engines arrive.
Yes, sir.
That's a good engine. Now, get to work.
Alan smiled and then puffed out of the station.
Later that same evening.
Late that night, Henry coupled up to the Flying Kipper as usual.
Everything okay, Henry? You seem tired and stressed.
I am, Pug. I haven't slept for a few days.
Who's taking the Wild Nor'wester?
Scott is. That'll help take the stress off my mind. But we have so much work.
Maybe talk to Sir Topham Hatt.
I might. Oh, that's my guard's whistle. I better go.
Good luck, Henry.
Nothing here yet. But Henry was so tired, when he arrived at Vickerstown, he puffed into the sheds to get some sleep.
Thank you.
Meanwhile...
The next day, Stepney was puffing into Barrow Station when he saw a diesel engine. She looked lost.
Hello, miss. You look lost. May I help?
Is this the way to the island of Sodor?
Of course, my dear. I'm happy to help you get there. I'm Stepney. Who might I ask are you?
Mavis.
Well, come on, Mavis. Follow me. Oh, it's a lovely place. You will love it.
Thank you.
Ah, Stepney. Thank you for coming in our hour of need.
No problem, sir.
Ah, you must be Mavis. I'm Sir Bertram Tottenham. Welcome to Sword.
Thank you, sir.
Sir, are these engines from the island of Newchester?
Aye, indeed we are. I'm Andrew. We've been asked by our manager to come and help you all.
And who are the rest of these wonderful engines?
Ah, Stepney, Mavis. I would love for you to meet Mullis, Heather, Evelyn, Marvin, George, Cody, Manchester, Tony and Allison.
Right. Stepney, I would like you to take Mavis to the Farquhar branch line.
Yes, sir. Come along, Mavis.
Coming!
Now, Andrew, another engine will take you to our larger engine sheds. Anthony, will you be able to run and get Henry, please?
Right. Wake up, Henry.
What is it?
So Topham Hatt needs you at the platform right away.
Okay. Yes, sir. Just tired. And you said you needed me for something?
Yes. I need you to take these to our additional roundhouse, the one which the LMS kindly built for us in the 1930s.
Oh, right, the additional one near Tidmouth. Yes, sir. Has control been informed?
Better send a message to the Sigurdmen, alerting them about it. They also know about Mavis and Stepney.
You last came here in 1934. Oh, it was a wonderful time.
You can say that again, Edward.
So, what's going on? Henry told me that Gordon is in shock and will be released on Christmas Day. And Thomas is in a coma?
Edward's face fell.
Yes, Thomas is in a coma. But do not tell Evelyn this. It'll break her heart. But tomorrow, you'll be taking Annie and Clara back.
Tops.
Welcome to the Sodor crew, Stepney.
Evening, engines!
Alan, it's been so long. You've grown so much.
Thank you, Adam.
Stepney, this is Alan, the younger brother of the steam slicer.
Please, Edward, I am not ashamed by it. Stephen was my brother. What he did to this railway was shameful and disgraceful.
I agree, but are you going to be working here again?
I will be. My wife and I are settled wonderfully back on Sodor. Our house at Barrow is still being used by our children. I will be working as a teacher at Vickerstown.
Well, it's a pleasure to meet you, Alan.
It is a pleasure indeed. Good night, engines.
Good night, Al.
Well, it was good to see him again.
Indeed. Well, I better get going. The Wellsworth mail won't take itself.
Have fun, Emma!
Good evening, everyone.
Evening, Eddie. Everyone okay at home?
Let's hope the mail is ready for us.
Oh, aye. There you are. Ah, Evelyn! We are grateful to have you help us with our mail run.
No problem. Andrew said Thomas usually helps. Where is he?
Well, he's at the works currently. But we are happy to have you lot helping us.
Indeed, we are. Thank ye and your crew.
We are glad to help you in your time in need.
Well, I am glad to have some help with my mail runs.
Oh, why? The Little Western has boosted up passengers and the extra help has helped us with great rails.
Right, everyone. Here's your locations for tonight. Edward, you'll be taking the post to Wellsworth.
Aye, sir.
Duncan Oliver, you're on the Little Western.
Naturally.
With Great Western pride.
Percy and number four, you're both on the Farquhar branch.
Oh, aye, sir.
And Evelyn, you're heading to Vickerstown. Another engine will be adding the rest of the train to theirs.
Of course, sir.
Well, good luck and good night.
Well, time for us to go. Don't worry, Evelyn. Linda is waiting for you in Vickerstown. Jinzy will be keeping you company at the show. And for Max, one of our heavy goods engines.
Thank you for the advice, Edward.
Good luck, Evelyn.
And with that, the five engines set off to their locations with the mail. Evelyn was the last to leave with the mail bound for Vickerstown.
With our solo friends.
Indeed, Linda. How is everyone back home?
They are well. Mr. Dawson is also wanting a report back on how well you're doing here. Don't worry. It's nothing too serious. He's just worried about you. You are only a young engine, after all.
I'm doing fine. The engines here are lovely. Thomas has such a wonderful branch line.
That he does. I have been on it once or twice.
Nathan and Simon will be coming over with some passengers for the island.
I can't wait!
Well, I'd best be going as soon as I am coupled to the train.
Well, we better get some sleep.
I agree!
Oh, you must be Evelyn.
I am?
It's a pleasure to finally meet you, after hearing so much about you from the other engines.
Thomas speaks very highly of you.
He does?
Indeed. He adores you as his little sister. Says that you remind him of his late sister, 106 Ivy.
That's sweet. I think I met her after my build date. I think.
Well, he adores you.
Aww, that's really sweet.
Right, Evelyn, we better get some sleep.
The next day, Mavis was full of energy as it was her first official day at the quarry.
Morning, Toby.
Morning, Mavis. Are you ready for the day?
Oh yes, I'm so excited.
Toby chuckled as he began to show Mavis the routine of the quarry.
So, you got the routine?
I think so.
Well, give it a go then, lass.
Okay, here we go.
As Mavis carefully shunted.
Okay. Here we go.
Toby was impressed.
Well done, lass. I'm impressed.
Thank you, Toby.
Anytime.
Though, I must say, you could modernize the route a bit. It's a bit outdated.
Outdated? This routine was made by Thomas. God bless him in his coma.
Wait! He was in a coma?
Yes, yes, sadly.
Hello, James.
Evening, Betty Group.
Brr, it's cold, and I am hoping that steam slicer doesn't come tonight.
Bah!
What all the rubbish? There's no such thing.
James! He might hear you. Edward said that the steam slicer doesn't take kindly to being mocked.
And you believe that stuff? There's no such thing as a steam... Hello?
Hello there, Jimmy. Come here.
Edward, Thomas, Henry, Percy, whoever it is, it isn't funny. Thomas! Yay! They're pushing me.
What should we do with him, sir?
Rebuild him? Scrap him? I don't know. But it's clear he cannot be trusted.
No! Stop! Thomas?
Help, 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 help! She's after me!
What?
Help! No! Stay away!
James screamed as he puffed away as fast as his wheels could carry him.
The NWR 100 replica doing, Mark?
Slow, sir. We have been lucky not to be spotted.
Aye. We must be lucky that we haven't been spotted. We must get this done.
Are you sure doing this secret project is a good idea, sir? What if the board finds out?
If the board finds out, they'll have me to answer to. I am grateful for this, Mark. After giving you a huge promotion for this.
Oh, wow, Sir Topham, this is too much. I can't possibly accept this.
Please accept this. We'll help you and your family.
Two months had passed since the events of October. Sir Topham Hatt had received the news that Gordon would be released the next day, and updates on Thomas were slow as well.
How are you feeling, Gordon?
I'm still a little shook, but I think I'll be fine.
Well, I have signed the release form, so you can go to the shed tonight if you would like to.
Yes, sir, of course. And with that, the big blue engine left the steamworks. News of Gordon leaving reached every engine, big and small.
Have you heard the news? Yon Gordon is out of the works and on his way back.
You know, I hear he and Scotsman may actually double-head the express as well.
Going around.
Oh, right. That is good news. When will we be back on the express?
Boxing Day. Scott has been doing a splendid job with Wild Norwester. But I think to top him up, we'll have Gordon on the goods work tomorrow.
From what I heard from Atlas, Gordon is in fine fettle.
I think I can hear him now. I can hear the thundering of his wheels.
Blimey, your hearing must be good, Ollie.
Oliver was right. Gordon puffed past the engines.
He seems in fine fettle indeed.
I agree with you on Stewie.
Let's hope everything goes well for him.
The guard whistle blew, and William had to go. Finally back home.
Well, it is joyful to see you home again.
Thank you, Edward. How has Scott managed with the Wild Nor'wester?
Quite well, though he has been quite tired.
Grit, coal, and experience.
Well, you'd better get some rest.
I know I should, but...
Thomas is coming out of his coma?!
Wait, what? How did you find this out?
At last! Driver phoned up the quarry!
Blimey, Percy! Calm down! But Percy wouldn't listen. He raced ahead, nearly breaking a quarry wall. Henry braked hard as Percy puffed past him. Whoa! Percy, watch it!
Sorry, Henry!
I swear we're all a bit batty on this island.
I heard many engines on the mainland are already being scrapped.
This is an outrage. We have been running the rails of the United Kingdom in Sodor for 141 years.
I hope this doesn't happen to our island.
I don't know. I heard a rumor that this Beeching fellow is coming to Sodor.
Curse the Dr. Beeching! I would love to give him a piece of my mind!
We know you would, Ken...
Whoa!
Percy! Slow down!
Percy, what was that for?
Are you all right, Colin?
Percy didn't respond as he puffed faster toward the steamworks.
Where are you? I know you're there. Show yourself. You know what I think? I think you're a coward. You use my shape to disguise yourself, to break me.
You will never learn, brother.
No. No. Timothy?
Hello, Thomas. My little brother.
No. No, I'm not seeing this.
Oh, you are seeing me, Tommy.
But you're dead.
Wrong. I've never felt so alive.
Why are you doing this? Why are you doing? Why are you in my head? Get out! Get out of my head!
Oh no. We're going to have a very good chat, Tommy.
Why are you here?
I'm here to show you the truth. How you had everything, and I had nothing. You see, I was the first of our family. I paved the way for the Thomas the Tank Engine. What do I forget? I'm God forgotten. I gave meant nothing but love, and you betrayed me!
I did no such thing. It's decades since you died. And I still love the real you. Not my, not this demonic monster. He's not my brother. Charles, help me. Is that you? Please, free me from him. I need to be away from him. Tommy, don't leave me with him.
Percy quickly puffed up to the words.
Ah, Percy! Just in time!
Has he woken up?
Not yet!
As Percy looked on, Thomas's eyes slowly started to open.
Cheese.
Wait, what? Ow! My eyes!
Don't worry, it's only a camera flash.
What a drama queen!
Oh dear.
Atlas, do you know where the paint pots are?
I think we left him on the other side, you think.
Get caught.
Trust me, mate. You won't get caught.
I broke my leg for the last deal.
I don't care. Listen. We need money. We need... Metal.
I beg your pardon. Scrapping Northwestern Railway engines? That'll cause a scandal.
I don't care. Listen, we need the money, and we will pay you very handsomely for it. Otherwise, we will bring harm upon your brother, and you don't want that, Do you?
Don't you dare touch Alan.
Oi, don't talk to the boss that way.
Settle down, Brian. So are you going to do it, or do you want your brother to be hard?
Fine. Which engines do you need?
Good boy.
Stephen groaned.
Oi! I've said it before, Joseph, and I'll say it again. My husband doesn't want you and your gang here. It's bad for my business. Now scram!
Oh, don't worry, Doris. We were just leaving.
And with that, the gang left, leaving Stephen worried and stressed.
Thomas is out of his coma!
Wait, he's in a coma?
He's been in a coma since October. The steam slicer attacks have been occurring since.
Yeah, he was. Didn't Tyree tell you about that?
Oh, I may have forgotten.
He's currently at the castle, getting some therapy. What on earth?
Is that Gordon?
Sure sounds like him.
It was Gordon. He came squealing into Marin. His sudden stop caused the coaches to bang into each other. The passengers were fuming, and they got out of the coaches to give the big blue engine a piece of their mind, when suddenly they could hear crying.
Everyone back on the train now! Molly, could you shunt us into the sidings?
Eric, you, Devon, and Molly need to triplehead this train to Vickerstown, please.
Molly and Devon were about to start when Eric spoke up.
But I have a goods train to take soon.
And I have a mixed goods to take as well.
Eric, Devon, this is important. Molly can't pull this train on her own.
But by some sheer luck, Manchester arrived.
Oh dear, what has happened?
Gordon's had some sort of panic attack and can't take his train to Vickerstown. Molly isn't strong enough to take it, and Eric and Devon both have a goods train soon, and we can't find any available engine.
I'll take him and the express to Vickerstown myself.
The engines and crew were surprised.
Manchester? Are you sure you can?
Of course, sir. And we do need to get these passengers to their station on time.
And the A3s set off.
Come on, Doncaster. Doncaster, you know you can talk to me.
But Gordon said nothing. He couldn't process it all.
Oh dear. Is Gordon okay?
Ugh, he had a panic attack whilst taking the express.
Oh dear.
Manchester shunted his brother onto the turntable and went back to pull the express.
Get some rest, Gordon.
Eventually, Manchester left the express, but then there was trouble. As the table was halfway round, Gordon began to move, thus jamming the table, and couldn't stop himself from slithering into a ditch.
Ooh, get me out! Get me out!
Oh, crud! Gordon, are you okay?
Oh dear, now we're stuck.
How lovely.
You're not helping me, Oliver.
Great, now my shunting will be backed up.
Ugh, Rosie will make a muck-up of my yard.
May I heed you, lovely gentleman? We have bigger problems right now.
Which is what, Emily, my dear?
Gordon had an anxiety attack again. His mental health is more important than your train or the yard's sorting arrangements.
She was right. Gordon's anxiety attack caused delays, with some so big the railway was set back behind. Henry and Peter were tasked with pulling Gordon out of the ditch.
And there we go.
Phew. Man, he's heavy. And yet, we are one of the strongest engines on Sodor.
Henry, Peter, I want you two to take Gorn to Orlstead Castle.
Yes, sir.
That's the sixth anxiety attack he's had, sir. Is Gordon even still fit for the express?
Oh, I agree with Ollie.
Well, it will be at Ulfstead Castle for a while.
I hope it works.
Same!
Oh, good gracious, what happened?
Gordon had another anxiety attack, this time on the turntable at Vickerstown.
It took them hours to get this sorted, so me and Henry were asked by Sir Topham Hatt to take him here.
Oh no, how long is he going to be in here?
Roughly 6 weeks until he's ready.
I'm worried about him, Thomas.
I am as well.
Well, in more positive news, are we ready for the King's speech?
Oh yes. I always look forward to the speeches from the King of Sodor and sometimes the Queen of the United Kingdom.
Edward enjoys the speeches the most, as he's met the other monarchs in the past.
As Henry uncoupled from Gordon, Peter shunted him into a siding. The engines were worried about Gordon, as they never expected him to be so badly affected by this. At around 5 o'clock that afternoon, the engines and staff were all waiting to hear the King's speech.
Pray silence for His Majesty, King Geoffrey I of Sodor.
I am speaking to you all, my fellow Sudrians. Christmas Day 1965 marks a wonderful year for our island. We mark 13 years of peace on our island since the passing of our beloved Queen Elizabeth II of Sodor. We have seen a lot of changes to our island and industries. Sir Bertram Topham Hatt and his enterprising engines in particular have worked tirelessly to ensure that we help our sister country England in support of the World Cup. I imagine our island's children must be excited for the World Cup. Myself and my sons, Prince Albert and George, are most excited to watch the matches from the comfort of our own home in Wellsworth, just like any other family on Sodor. The Queen is wanting to thank you for your kind words and wishes following the recent news of Her Majesty expecting. With that, I wish you all a very Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
The engines whistled, and the staff cheered. As the days went on, and the new year came in, no strange ghostly incidents. Or so it was told.
Outrageous! British Railways want Sir Topham Hatt to take Gordon off the Wild Nor'wester and replace him with a diesel!
87546, calm yourself. Getting angry solves nothing.
How would you feel?
I too am worried for my little brother. I pray he recovers. Oh, Gordon. Yes, sir. Of course.
Good luck.
Valentine's Day came and went. Nothing was celebrated with the engines as they couldn't, and they had work to do. At Croven's Gate, the little engines were talking about the skids at the large steam gauge railway.
I am telling you, I thought I saw the ghost that's terrorizing the standard gauge engines.
Smudger and Duncan just rolled their eyes. Peter Sam had been making the most ridiculous claims the past week.
Honestly, Stowie, you're taking a load of ballast, just like when we was on the MSR.
I am not. I saw the alleged steam slicer.
Peter Sam, it's the standard gauge engines who are dealing with this ghost, Markley, not us.
It's like being on the MSR again.
He can't have been that bad, surely.
Oh, he was.
Hey!
Oh, God. Pipe down, you two. Some of us are still asleep.
Oh, whatever, Eddie. It's just sleep.
A bit of common decency would be appreciated here, Smudger. You just can't say you're going to improve your image and then suddenly go back to how you were before.
Whatever.
You were like this on the MSMR, the Dookie. You never showed him respect when it came to sleep.
Duke was an old fuddy-duddy who could never shut up about his precious grace.
Some things never change.
Ho 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 ho! So you keep saying, Bertie. So you keep saying.
Oh, another day of hard work and I can finally rest my aching wheel!
You said it, Edward.
Though what brings you here, Bert?
Sir Topham asked me to deliver a special train here and said I could sleep here at the sheds. I hope you all don't mind.
Oh, of course not, Bert. You are welcome here.
Though Percy was distracted, but then the trouble began. Cracks started to appear in the sheds.
Anyone out?
Put a hole?
No!
Thank you.
The engines blew their whistles and horns. Suddenly, the rails began to wobble as the island shook. But the engines of Soto were not afraid. This is their home. This is the final battle. Stop that!
Not on your life, laddie!
For Soto!
For Soto! Weesh after weesh, rock after rock, the steam slicer was so distracted he never saw Alan jump out of Edward's cab.
Are you sure about this?
Yes! It's up to you, Alan!
Aha!
Oh, haggis!
That had to be embarrassing.
Right, Lucky!
Why won't he stay still?
Come on!
Ah!
Ouch!
Oh dear!
Whoa! Ooh! Ouchie!
That had to hurt.
Wow!
Ow!
Are you alright?
Yes, quite.
Oi! That's my line! Eek!
I got it in the right place!
Good!
Stay in place, Edward!
Wait! No, Alan, wait!
Whoa!
The night sky cleared. The engines looked around. They were all silent. Did it work?
It did!
The engines cheered, blew whistles, honked horns, and the workmen celebrated.
We did it! But dead but sheds, it's destroyed! So many years of rest at this place, gone!
Where will the mainline crew sleep?
Fear not, Stanley. The first controller will find places for the mainline to sleep.
I am pretty sure the Ironworks can supply the rebuild project.
Thank his majesty, the King of Sodor isn't here to see this!
Don't speak so soon, Geoffrey. The engines looked upon the damaged site of Tiddle's sheds and sighed as they puffed away to sleep elsewhere. The next day, Gordon, Thomas, and the other engines were told of the incident, with Tiddler Sheds by Percy.
He's gone! We won!
Are you sure, Pass?
Yes, indeed. I don't fancy getting another panic attack.
Yes! We saw it all happen!
Well, I don't think you're ready for the Wild Nor'wester for a while.
So Topham said Rebecca or Henry are taking it, or my brothers as well.
Hey. But we are worried about you and Thomas.
We know you a lot.
And we thank you. And then James arrived with the Fat Controller.
Morning, you two. How are you feeling?
A little bit better, thank you, James. What brings you here, though?
Well, we have some news that... we're all ghost-free, and I brought Sir Topham with me as well. But I'm sorry to say that Titmus Shed was destroyed by the steam slicer.
Gordon was sad that his home was destroyed, but he smiled when Sir Topham jumped out of James's cab.
Well, I am happy to say that Tidmouth Shed will be rebuilt into a 7-bed shed. It will take us a few months to rebuild it, but we have the money, support, staff to do this main project. And a new surprise will be at Napford tomorrow.
Are we able to come to this surprise, sir?
Only if you feel ready and comfortable.
Gordon and Thomas looked at each other for a minute. They smiled.
Oh, we would love to come.
I second that.
Marvellous. Now, Jane, I'd like you to take me to the search and rescue.
Yes, sir. Climb aboard.
Make sure you two get the rescue made.
Yes, sir. As James left, Topham looked at Thomas, hoping this surprise didn't send him into shock. As the next day came, the big event happened. Most of the engines were at Napford Station as the Topham Hat made the announcement.
I would like to welcome everyone to this special announcement. As you are all aware, Tidmouth Shed was destroyed by some unknown force, but it has been dealt with. But rest assured, we will rebuild the shed to a 7-berth shed where we can host more engines hopefully. Now, I would like to reveal this new project that has been in the works since October 31st, 1950. Engines, staff, and the people of Sordor, please welcome NWR number 100, Gerard.
Then a whistle was heard. As the sound puffing could be heard, and the pulling coaches on platform 1 was Jerome with 4 coaches. Thomas's eyes widened as the shape was very similar to his.
I'm sorry, Thomas. I understand the shock and understanding, but I'm not Timothy. I may have been built from his remains, but I am not him.
Are you sure, sir?
Yes, Thomas. We even had our local vicar to use some ritual to check if Timothy was there, and he isn't. I can assure you that.
Although Thomas looked uneasy as he looked at the engine next to him, it took a while, but he smiled. The people cheered.
Well, is this philosopher still ready for Titmouth Sheds?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Yes, it is.
Are you sure?
Yes, I am sure, Marklin. Jeez, Timothy, calm down. It was only a question. He does this every time, Chris. It's getting annoying.
All right, stop it, both of you. This isn't the time for bickering. We have a shed to rebuild, and it won't be done unless you want to continue arguing.
Boko is right. Arguing solves nothing.
Sorry, Edward. Who is picking up the loads from Minerva?
Well, according to the timetable, Mavis, Theo, Toby, and Jacob are gonna shunt the trains for Lee, Anderson, James, and Adam to take to Elsbridge. Henry and Hero will get them the rest of the way.
Are you sure you want to pull that heavy load, Edward?
Edward chuckled.
I may be 66 years of age, but I can still give you both a run for your coal.
Oh yeah, Edward. I'm sure you can.
Watch the cheek, you two.
Okie dokie, Boko.
Whatever you say, Boko.
Right. You're all good to go. Boko, you're at the back, and Edward is triple-heading with Chris and Marklin.
Huh. Down to Timothy.
Right, let's go!
and with a puff and a huff, the engines left the clay works with their large load for timber sheds. As could be said, the engines doing the overloads, which they, when they got to Ellsbridge, without delay for Henry and Hero. Thank you for the trucks.
Ready, Henry?
Ready, Hero?
Heave! Pull!
And Henry and Hero left Ellsbridge with their loads for timber sheds.
Come on, team!
Good, Wellsworth, this is heavy.
Let's go. Good Topham, how much stone do they need?
With a heave and a hoe, the four engines made it to the wrecked side of Timmer's sheds.
Thank goodness you lot brought the stone. The construction can now begin properly. Shouldn't take long. It shouldn't take long to have her rebuilt back, and so the mainline crew won't complain about having no shed.
Thank you.
Here we go. Fresh steel to help with the support of the walls.
Thank you, Bert and Frankie.
Aye, no problem. We'll be dropping more later in the afternoon.
Thank you.
Right, let's go, Frankie, before Harry cooks up a fuss.
How long would it take for Tidmouth Sheds to be rebuilt?
About roughly 5 months. The China Clay Works and the Norfolk Quarry have been contracted for it.
Oh, thank God. I am sick of hearing James complaining about how a splendid red engine like him has to sleep elsewhere.
Oh, I agree with you on that subject. It is annoying.
Edward, Hero, Boko, and Henry laughed as the work began on Tidmouth. As time went on, the site was cleaned up, and construction began on the sheds. This time, the men opted for a 7-berth shed instead of the original 6-berth shed, which had been there previously.
Thank you.
want to let you know that I messed up. Despite both of us having a job in the Northwestern, it wasn't enough to make ends meet. I was desperate. I needed a solution. And then I got mixed up with those guys who threatened to harm you. You wear what will have or is to come. I want to let you know that I am not happy with what I'm going to do, but I assume you won't like it either. I am truly sorry, little brother. I hope in time you will forgive me. Much love, your big brother.
Stevie!
And then the great day of the world came.
And he's about to shoot the goal. And he's done it! England has won the World Cup!
The engines cheered, as did everyone also. Everyone cheers as the sheds were opened, the mainline crew were especially happy as the railway began to return to normal. The engines of the island of Newchester weren't needed.
To have helped there.
It has truly been an honour to help out here again.
Aww, do we have to go?
Then don't worry, Evie. We'll be back again someday, and I'm sure we'll have some scheduling help in our home as always.
You can definitely say that again.
Don't forget the rhyme.
Yeah, I want to hear more stories.
I'll tell you some later tonight, Percival.
I would like to thank your manager for loaning you lot to us in our time of need.
It's no problem, sir. Happy to help.
Has the line been cleared for us, sir?
Safe travels indeed.
Hope to see you again.
Percy could manage and be more dependent without me. Glad I could help. And I'm glad Percy learned to manage without you. Toby mainly helped on that front. As am I. Though, I have heard rumours that Sir Topham may be reopening the old Kirk Ronan branch. I have a feeling Percy could run that branch. You think so? I know so. He is ready to run a branch of his own. I want him to branch out of his coal bunker. Because he has made subtle hints of wanting his own line. Thinking that we weren't listening to his little rants. Well, I hope he does get the branch. As do I, dear cousin.
Wine's all clear, Steps. Ready to go.
Is that everything loaded?
Double checked with the yard foreman. It is.
Well, I wish you dry rails and smooth runnings on your trip back home. Don't forget to write. Don't worry, Tommy, old boy. I won't forget. Are we ready, driver?
All good here, Thomas.
Okay, off we go.
He's a really useful engine, you know. All the other engines, they'll tell you so. He huffs and puffs and whistles, rushing to and fro. He's the really useful engine we adore. He's the one. He's the really useful engine that we adore. He's the number one, Thomas the Tank Engine. He's a really useful engine, you know. 'Cause the Fat Controller, he told him so. Now he's got a branch line to call his very own. He's the really useful engine we adore. He's the one. He's the really useful engine that we adore. He's the one. He's the number one. Thomas the Tank Engine. Little Blue Train, he's always there whenever you need a hand. If you need help with a situation, who comes into mind? He's the one. He's the really useful engine that we adore. He's the one. He's the number one. Thomas the Tank Engine.
Did you hear that the semi-private branch line will be opening on Sodor?
I did hear. The Callenbill branch, I believe it's called.
I heard Mr. Wadsworth is talking to Mr. Hatt about it.
Is he now?
Well, I hope we get there.
I do as well.